good evening, everybody.
Guten Abend alle zusammen.
Let's begin with prayer.
Lass uns anfangen mit Gebet.
Dear Heavenly Father.
Lieber himmlischer Vater.
Lord, I want to thank you for blessing us this day.
Herr, ich will dir danken, dass du uns heute gesegnet hast.
I want to pray now that you would help my brother Elias.
Und ich möchte jetzt beten, dass du meinem Bruder Lorenz hilfst.
That when he opens your word.
Dass wenn er dein Wort öffnet.
That you give him clear thoughts and direct him according to your will.
Dass du ihm klare Gedanken schenken mögest und ihn gemäß deines Willens führen magst.
Help us to be attentive.
Hilf uns, dass wir aufmerksam sind.
And that it will direct our minds to the point that you intend us to understand.
Dass du unseren Verstand in die Richtung führen mögest zu den Punkten, die wir verstehen sollen.
And that you will bless the, both the technical and the translation.
Und dass du sowohl die Technik als auch die Übersetzung segnen mögest.
And that you will bless us with your presence.
Und dass du uns segnest mit deiner Gegenwart.
And we ask this in the name of Jesus.
Und wir bitten das im Namen Jesu.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, so this evening we want to look at some pioneer understanding on the issue of the Sunday law. Okay.
Und heute Abend wollen wir uns das Pionierverständnis über das Thema des Sonntagsgesetzes anschauen.
And we'll see that at the moment with the vaccination, you can see this very same mindset, this oppressive spirit that is being manifested.
Und wir können das jetzt auch sehen mit der Impfung, dass genau derselbe unterdrückerische Geist eben manifestiert wird.
And this is what I intend to show you, that I want to show you how I will show you later some readers' comments, you know, about people that post their thoughts, okay?
Und das ist eben meine Absicht. Ich möchte euch zeigen, ja, auch ein paar
Leserkommentare
über ihre Gedanken.
Because we need to understand, right? We are here in our own sphere, let's say, okay?
Und wir müssen verstehen, wir sind hier in unserer eigenen Sphäre.
And we don't get so much in contact with people outside in the world, with this, let's say, the which are the majority of the people, okay?
Und wir kommen nicht so sehr,
the mainstream.
Wir kommen nicht so sehr in Kontakt mit den Leuten da draußen, also mit dem Mainstream, mit der Mehrheit der Leute.
And but it's always interesting because in the internet, yeah, they always openly manifest in what they believe and what they think, okay?
Das ist immer interessant, weil im Internet da tun sie das immer offen manifestieren, was sie glauben und denken.
Yeah, because there they are anonymous and then they feel at liberty now to basically just utter their sentiments, okay?
Weil dort sind sie anonym und da fühlen sie sich dann frei, ihre Ausdrücke ja, zu sagen.
And therefore it's very fearful to see how the people already think, okay?
Deswegen ist es sehr furchtsam zu sehen, wie die Leute jetzt schon denken.
And we need to realize that this vaccination mandate can come much quicker than we think. Okay.
Wir müssen realisieren, dass dieser Impfzwang-Dekret eben schneller kommen kann, als wir denken.
Because the population is already ready for it. They already have the spirit, and you can see it, and they like, you know, they push the like button when people voice and ask for a vaccination mandate.
Weil die Bevölkerung ist schon bereit dafür. Sie zeigen schon diesen Geist und ja, sie drücken immer dieses den Like-Button, wenn jemand sich eben für die Impfung äußert.
It's like this law at the moment, how I at least perceive it is that it's a ploy to force as many people as possible to get vaccinated or it's a ploy to get them to get vaccinated, so that there'll be much fewer when they bring the vaccine mandate. And you can see them already queuing up to get vaccinated in this day.
Und auch mit diesem, ja, mit diesem Lockdown für Ungeimpfte, also was gerade ist, das ist dazu bestimmt, dass sich eben so viele wie möglich impfen lassen, weil wenn dann dieses, dieser Impfzwang kommt, dass es dann nur sehr wenige sind, die sich dann noch nicht geimpft haben. Und ja, man kann schon sehen, wie sie jetzt eben sich anreihen, und, um diese Impfung zu erhalten.
Yes. Okay, so let's look at here this article by A.T. Jones.
Dann schauen wir uns jetzt diesen Artikel von A.T. Jones an.
And he wrote about this national reform movement in back in his time, in the 1888 issue about the Sunday law.
Okay. Und er hat über diesen, dieses nationale Reformbewegung geschrieben in seiner Zeit, im Jahr 1886, wo das Thema mit dem Sonntagsgesetz aufkam.
Yeah, because this was basically this movement that wanted to bring the Sunday law back then already.
Weil das war eben diese Bewegung, die schon damals dieses Sonntagsgesetz bringen wollte.
Okay, so and let's read about it.
Lesen wir das.
It says here, the avowed purpose of the National Reform Party is to secure an amendment to the Constitution of the United States, by which every man will be compelled to acknowledge that God is sovereign, that Christ is ruler, and that the Bible is the supreme law. Whether a man believes it or not is no difference. He must be compelled to acknowledge it because they profess to believe it. This Christian statesman of October 2nd, 1848 says, give all men to understand that this is a Christian nation, and that, believing that without Christianity we perish, we must maintain by all right means our Christian character, inscribe this character on our constitution, and force upon all that come among us the laws of Christian morality. Okay, so what is their goal? What do they want to do?
Also, was ist ihr Ziel? Was wollen sie tun?
Force a false religion upon people.
No, they want to force the Christian religion upon people. Okay.
Sie wollen die christliche Religion auf den Leuten aufzwingen.
And obviously their understanding is false, but even if they had the correct understanding of Christianity, it would still false. Okay.
Und natürlich ihr Verständnis ist falsch, aber selbst wenn sie das richtige Verständnis über das Christentum hätten, wäre es trotzdem falsch, es zu zwingen.
Okay. And they therefore, in order to achieve this goal, they want to amend the constitution. That's what he says. Okay.
Und dieses Ziel zu erreichen, müssen sie eben die Verfassung ändern.
Okay. Next paragraph.
Nächster Absatz.
And force, according to Webster, is to force, to constrain, to compel, to execute with vigor. Therefore, the proposition of these national reformers is to force, to compel, all to keep the laws of Christian morality, to execute with vigor upon all the laws of Christian morality. And what is to be the penalty for dissent? Well, they pretend to be so kind that they will not whip anybody for it. They pretend to be so liberal that they will not impose a fine upon anyone for it. They pretend to be so merciful that they will not imprison anyone for it. But they are neither so kind, so liberal, nor so merciful, but that they will disfranchise everyone who will not acknowledge and submit to the provisions which they choose to embody in their religious amendment to the Constitution. Okay, so they claim not to basically use violence to make you obey these Christian laws.
Also sie behaupten, dass sie keine Gewalt anwenden, um dich dazu zu bringen, diesen religiösen Gesetzen zu gehorchen.
Which is obviously nonsense, because Sister White says, whenever they will compel the conscience, they will use violence. Okay.
Und das ist natürlich Unsinn, weil Ellen White sagt ja, wann auch immer sie das Gewissen zwingen werden, wenn sie...
They will use violence.
Werden sie Gewalt anwenden.
But here they just say, all right, we will disenfranchise everyone will not acknowledge these Christian laws.
Aber hier sagen sie eben, dass sie diejenigen entrechten werden, die nicht mit diesen religiösen
Gesetzen.
Mit den religiösen Gesetzen eben übereinstimmen werden.
Okay. It says, thus for religious opinion, however conscientiously held, which may disagree with theirs, they deliberately propose to deprive men of their birthright to the most inestimable right of the earth, that for which thousands upon thousands have laid down their lives, that for which our fathers pledged their lives, their fortunes, and their sacred honor, the right to be a citizen amongst a free people, and in this instance a citizen of the best government or the earth. Every honor to which he might otherwise aspire, every right to which he might otherwise be entitled, must be swept away at one stroke, because, forsooth, he chooses to claim the right to worship God according to the dictates of his own conscience. That this is no fancy picture that we have drawn, that it is no fable that we have devised in regard to what that party proposes to do, we have abundant proof, and that in their own words. So now he will quote their own words, okay?
Also jetzt wird ihre eigenen Worte zitieren.
Mr. W. J. Coleman is one of the principal exponents of the National Reform Religion. In the Christian Statement of November 1st, 1883, Mr. Coleman replied to some questions that had been put by a correspondent who signed himself Truth Seeker. We copy the following. Quote, what effect would the adoption of the Christian Amendment, together with the proposed changes in the Constitution, have upon those who deny that God is the sovereign, Christ the ruler, and the Bible the law? This brings up the conscience question at once. The classes who would object are, as Truth Seeker has said, Jews, infidels, atheists, and others. These classes are perfectly satisfied with the Constitution as it is. How would they stand toward it if it recognized the authority of our Lord Jesus Christ? To be perfectly plain, I believe that the existence of a Christian Constitution would disfranchise every logically consistent infidel. Okay, so this was this quote.
Also das war dieses Zitat.
Now, E.T. Jones goes on to say.
Jetzt sagt E.T. Jones weiter.
There we have in plain words what they propose to do with dissenters under the Christian Constitution. But let us look into this a little further. Notice, it is only the logically consistent dissenter that will be disfranchised. By the same token, then, the illogically inconsistent can all be citizens. That is, the man of honest intention, of firm conviction, and of a real principle, who values his principles more than he does political preference, he must be disfranchised. While the time servers, the political hacks, the man of no convictions and of no principle, they can all be acceptable citizens. In other words, the honest man, if he be a dissenter, cannot be a citizen. But every hypocrite can be a citizen. Therefore, the inevitable logic of the national reformer's position is to put a premium upon hypocrisy. And such will be the value of citizenship under their so-called Christian constitution. And so basically, yeah, what the logical outcome is, those that are honest and stand firm for the principle, they will lose their citizenship.
Also die logische Konsequenz dazu ist eben, dass diejenigen, die ehrlich sind und zu ihren Prinzipien stehen, sie werden ihr Bürgerrecht verlieren.
But those that are just then pretend to accept Christianity, they can remain citizens.
Okay. Aber die vorgeben, das Christentum anzunehmen, sie können Bürger bleiben.
So basically you basically promote hypocrisy with this.
Also okay. Damit förderst du eben Heuchelei.
Okay. And this obviously would then defile the Christian religion. Okay.
Und das würde dann natürlich die christliche Religion verunreinigen.
Okay. Such a result from such proceedings is not new. The Puritan Parliament solemnly resolved that no person shall be employed but such as the house shall be satisfied of his real godliness. And as the natural consequence, the realm was filled with hypocritical piety. Thus much merely in passing, as it is not so much our purpose in this article to notice the logic of the position, as it is to show the avowed purpose of outraging every principle of the rights of conscience. Mr. Coleman is not alone in thus defining the status of dissenters. In the Statesman of February 21, 1848, Mr. J. C. K. Milligan, in writing upon the same subject, expressed himself thus: "The worst result will be to disfranchise them." So that was a quote.
Also das war ein Zitat.
And now goes on to say, "But this is not the worst result which they wish, nor which they intended shall be to such. Just read carefully the following extract from an address delivered by Reverend E.B. Graham at a National Reform Convention held in York, Nebraska, and reported in the Christian Statesman of May 21st, 1885. Now again a quote.
Ein Zitat.
"We might add, in all justice, if the opponents of the Bible do not like our government and its Christian features, let them go to some wild, desolate land, and in the name of the devil, and for the sake of the devil, subdue it, and set up a government of their own on infidel and atheistic ideas, and then, if they can stand it, stay there till they die." Okay, so that was quote end.
Also jetzt ist das Zitat zu Ende.
Exactly. Dissenters must not only be disfranchised, they must all be sent to the devil, and that too in some wild and desolate land, and even that is not enough, but they must stay there till they die. And that is the national reform idea of justice. That is the kind of a government that they propose under the Christian constitution. Okay, so here you can see this has nothing to do with Christian principles. Okay.
Also hier können wir sehen, das hat nichts mit christlichen Prinzipien zu tun.
It's just radical, fanatical ideas. Okay.
Das sind nur radikale, fanatische Ideen.
But the same sentiment you can see basically with these vaccinations now. Okay.
Aber dieselben Neigungen kann man jetzt eben auch sehen mit der Impfung.
Because people they want to treat now the unvaccinated people as if they have no rights anymore.
Weil die Leute wollen jetzt die Ungeimpften so behandeln, als hätten sie keine Rechte mehr.
Yeah, they basically call them only they're uninformed and stupid and they have no idea what they basically stand for and all these things.
Und sie nennen sie dann uninformiert und dumm und sie haben keine Vorstellung für das, was sie stehen und all solche Dinge.
Okay. So, let's continue.
Lesen wir weiter.
"That is the way in which they propose to exemplify the sublime Christian principle of brotherly love, and the means which they will employ that brotherly love may continue. That is the way in which they are going to bring about the reign of universal peace, even as they say, the millennium itself. That will be indeed the reign of the saints. But a like scheme of the Christian endeavor of the Society of Jesus, there was peace once in the fair Waldensian valleys, but like exertions, Innocent III, it was this Pope back then,
Innocent der Dritte war dieser Papst damals,
succeeded in creating peace amidst the graceful scenery, the rich fields, and the splendid cities of Languedoc and Provence. This too is all to be done in behalf of liberty of conscience, that is, the conscience of the national reformers. They give us clearly to understand that it is entirely out of respect to their own consciences that they propose to do all these things." Mr. Coleman says further, in the place before quoted, now again a quote,
wieder ein Zitat.
"If there be any Christian who objects to the proposed amendment on the ground that it might touch the conscience of the infidel, it seems to me it would be in order to inquire whether he himself should not have some conscience in this matter. Okay, so it's not about the freedom of conscience of anybody apart from the so-called Christian. Okay.
Also es geht, also das Gewissen der anderen, die Gewissensfreiheit der anderen, darauf kommt es nicht an, als nur von diesen sogenannten Christen.
So, no, so he's done with the word conscience, broken into two, conscience. He was basically saying that it's not really conscience, it's a con, it's a false science this person has in his conscience.
Ah, okay, understand. I was wondering why you did this. Okay.
Das habe ich nicht verstanden.
Also er hat hier letztendlich dieses Wort conscience, hat er hier con und dann Bindestrich science geschrieben. Also con, also contra,
ja. Two words.
Genau, also das ist gegen, also es ist eine sozusagen eine falsche Wissenschaft ist. Ja. Science ist ja.
Con means to cheat, so it's a false science. It's basically instead of being conscience to do with your choices you make in your mind, he's changed it to two words that mean two completely different things.
Okay, so let's continue.
Also lesen wir weiter.
So then, in this national reform Christianity, it is the perfection of conscientiousness to outrage some other man's conscience. And the reverse of the golden rule becomes to them the law and the prophets. The chief complaint is that the present constitution disfranchises them, which is false, and therefore they must have it changed so that it will be that it will disfranchise everyone but them. So they basically say, under the present constitution, they get disfranchised.
Also but sie sagen, unter der gegenwärtigen Verfassung werden sie entrechtet.
And therefore they want to change it now, that everybody else gets disfranchised but then. Okay.
Und deswegen wollen sie das jetzt ändern, damit jeder andere entrechtet wird.
They don't get disfranchised, it says it's false.
Yes, yes. Making it right. Up. In the current constitution, nobody gets disfranchised.
Aber das ist natürlich falsch, weil mit der gegenwärtigen Verfassung wird niemand entrechtet.
Okay, next paragraph.
Nächster Absatz.
And so, all things whatsoever you would not that man should do to you, this do you even unto them. For this is the law of national reform. And who are they that propose to do these things? An association of which the vice president alone number 120, then whom we verily believe that there cannot be found in the United States an equal number of other men who could exert a more positive influence. In a complete list given in the Christian Statesman of December 2nd, 1883, we read the names of 13 bishops of such of the evangelical churches as have bishops, 15 college presidents, 13 college professors, 10 justices of supreme courts. And then he goes on to say also, you know, numbers no more, and we don't need to read this. But you can see that they're high supporters. Okay.
Also er zählt jetzt noch mehr auf und das müssen wir jetzt nicht lesen, aber wir können sehen, dass das eben hochrangige Unterstützer sind.
Next paragraph.
Nächster Absatz.
As for us, we are neither Jews, infidels, nor are atheists. Also now A.T. Jones speaks about us as Seventh-day Adventists. Okay.
Also jetzt spricht A.T. Jones über uns als Siebenten-Tags-Adventisten.
He says, as for us, we are neither Jews, infidels, nor atheists. But as we descend totally from the doctrines of the National Reform Party, we suppose, of course, and we are willing to confess that we belong to that fourth class to which Mr. Coleman referred by the phrase and others. Yeah, because he said Jews, infidels, and atheists and others are these people that needs to be disfranchised.
Weil er hat gesagt, Juden, Ungläubige, Atheisten und andere, die sollen entrechtet werden.
And we as Adventists would be among the other class, okay, und these others.
Wir als Adventisten, wir wären dann unter den anderen, unter dieser Klasse.
We do not deny that God is sovereign, nor that Christ is ruler, nor that the Bible is the supreme law. We freely confess all these. But while we confess that God is sovereign, we positively deny that he has delegated his sovereignty to the National Reform Party. While we confess that Christ is ruler, we deny that he has chosen the National Reform Party as his confidential advisors in his rule, or that he has appointed that party as his vicegerent in the United States to rule this country in his absence. While we confess that the Bible is the supreme standard of human actions, we deny in note that the author of the Bible has appointed the National Reform Party to be the infallible interpreters of that book. And because we distrust their movement, because we see the result of it when they shall have secured the power, they choose to think us possessed of a wonderful compound of folly and fanaticism. See editorial comment in Statesman on February 21st, 1884. But from their own words, fairly quoted in this article, we are justified in saying that the success of their movement will be the destruction of the dearly bought principle of American liberty, the destruction of the inestimable treasure of American citizenship, and the destruction of every principle of the rights of conscience under the government of the United States. And because of this, the American Sentinel, and the American Sentinel is this newspaper that he published, okay?
Und der amerikanische Sentinel, das ist dieser Zeitungsartikel, den er dort zitiert hat.
And because of this, the American Sentinel, no, it's that A.T. Jones published.
Achso, also den hat A.T. Jones veröffentlicht.
That's a newspaper.
Das ist diese Zeitung.
And because of this, American Sentinel is set for the defense of the genius of American institutions. Okay, so back then the Adventists, they defended the liberty of conscience by bringing out these newspapers. Okay.
So damals haben die Adventisten die Gewissensfreiheit verteidigt, indem sie diese Zeitungen gedruckt haben.
And they strongly opposed these national reformers.
Okay. Und sie haben ganz stark diese nationalen Reformer eben widerstanden.
And that's why also A.T. Jones then ended up in before the Senate hearing with the Blair Bill, which was this blueprint of a Sunday law.
Und deswegen kam dann auch A.T. Jones dann vor den Senat und kam dann mit.
And he basically gave his arguments against the so-called Blair Bill.
Okay. Und er hat dann eben seine Argumente gegen dieses sogenannte Blair Bill gegeben.
Which was the blueprint for the Sunday law.
Und das war eben der Blueprint für das Sonntagsgesetz.
Okay. So eine, sozusagen so eine Vorlage, ja, für das Sonntagsgesetz.
Eine Vorlage für das Sonntagsgesetz.
Okay. Alright, so we can definitely see in the many other quotes that A.T. Jones brings up in his newspaper articles.
Wir können jetzt hier sehen, und also bei A.T. Jones, der zitiert viele Zitate aus diesem Zeitungsartikel.
That they had this oppressive spirit, they wanted to basically get rid of everybody who was not in line with their thoughts. Okay.
Dass sie eben diesen unterdrückerischen Geist hatten und sie wollten jeden loswerden, der nicht denselben Gedankengang hatte wie sie.
And I remember still, you know, it was many, many years ago when I became a Christian. It's like, I watched a documentary, it was called The Jesus Camp.
Ich kann mich erinnern, vor vielen, vielen Jahren, als ich eben Christ geworden bin, da habe ich eine Dokumentation geschaut, die hieß Der Jesus Camp.
Das Jesuslager.
Das Jesuslager.
Okay. And there, basically, they showed these religious right-wing people in America.
Und da haben sie die religiösen Rechtsgerichteten in Amerika gezeigt.
And they showed how basically how they indoctrinate their children already from a young age.
Und dort haben sie gezeigt, wie sie ihre Kinder schon von in einem jungen Alter indoktrinieren.
And it was so fearful when I saw this. It's like because they actively want to go into the politics and they want basically to bring in, what they say, Jesus into America, in the American politics.
Und das war sehr furchtsam, weil sie wollen eben aktiv das in die Politik hereinbringen, was sie eben, in, also den sogenannten Jesus wollen sie eben in diese Politik einbringen in Amerika.
And how they acted, it was just pure fanatical, it was terrible.
Und wie sie sich verhalten haben, das war einfach nur reiner Fanatismus.
Okay, so therefore, yeah, when we think that these things are oppressive at the moment, yeah, when the Sunday law comes, it will be 1,000 times worse. Okay.
Und wenn wir denken, dass das jetzt im Moment unterdrückend ist, dann im Sonntagsgesetz wird das noch viel, also 1,000-mal schlimmer sein.
Okay, let's read this next quote, speaking about the Sunday law.
Lesen wir jetzt das nächste Zitat, das spricht über das Sonntagsgesetz.
It says here, the decree enforcing the worship of this day is to go forth to all the world. In a limited degree, it has already gone forth. In several places, the civil power is speaking with the voice of a dragon, just as the heathen king spoke to the Hebrew captives. Okay, so here we can see that in some countries, the governments will be already more oppressive than in other countries. Okay.
Also hier können wir sehen, dass in manchen Ländern wird die Regierung unterdrückender sein als in anderen Ländern.
We can also see this at the moment. Some countries are still with the vaccination still more, you know, reserved, but others like here Austria are already pretty oppressive. Okay.
Also das können wir auch im Moment sehen. Manche Länder, die sind mit der Impfung noch ein wenig zurückhaltend, aber hier in Österreich zum Beispiel ist es schon sehr unterdrückend.
Okay, next paragraph.
Nächster Absatz.
Trial and persecution will come to all who in obedience to the word of God refuse to worship this false Sabbath. Force is the last resort of every false religion. At first it tries attraction, as the king of Babylon tried the power of music and outward show. If these attractions, invented by man, inspired by Satan, failed to make men worship the image, the hungry flames of the furnace were ready to consume them. So it will be now. The papacy has exercised her power to compel man to obey her, and she will continue to do so. We need the same spirit that was manifested by God's servants in the conflict with paganism. Okay, so first, it always tries to attract you, right?
Also zuerst versucht es immer, dich anzuziehen.
And when we look at here the Sunday law crisis.
Und wenn wir uns die Sonntagsgesetzkrise anschauen.
Basically here, up to this point, yeah, they try to attract you, right?
Also bis zu diesem Punkt hier versuchen sie, dich eben anzuziehen oder zu locken.
Yeah, but then you are brought before the kings and now they bring the wrath against you, okay?
Aber dann wirst du vor die Könige gebracht werden und dann bringen sie den Zorn gegen dich.
Yeah, now they want to compel you by threat of death, okay?
Und jetzt wollen sie dich zwingen, indem sie dir den Tod androhen.
And also when we look at this vaccination issue.
Und auch wenn wir uns dieses Impfthema anschauen.
Yeah. Up till now they used many attractions, right?
Also bis jetzt haben sie sehr viele Attraktionen benutzt.
Okay, but we can see that they now come and say, we know we're patient long enough with you guys. Now we need to basically force you a little bit. Okay.
Aber jetzt sagen sie, jetzt waren wir schon lang genug mit euch geduldig und jetzt müssen wir euch eigentlich zwingen.
Okay, and it was just today that I read, and I posted it also in the Buchner group, that they are now here in Austria discussing already, or at least looking at the options to implement this general vaccine mandate. Okay.
Und ich habe gerade heute eben in den einen Zeitungsartikel gelesen, und das habe ich auch in die Buchner-Gruppe geschickt, dass sie eben jetzt schon darüber diskutieren, die Impfpflicht einzuführen.
Okay. So, they're looking at the options, okay.
Also, sie schauen sich die Optionen an, diese allgemeine Impfpflicht einzuführen.
Okay. So, Let's read the next quote.
Lesen wir das nächste Zitat.
And we need to understand it's the people that will demand this Sunday law or this vaccination mandate. Okay.
Wir müssen verstehen, dass es die Leute sind, die diese Impfpflicht dann fordern werden.
So let's read this next quote.
Lesen wir dieses nächste Zitat.
It says the dignitaries of church and state will unite to bribe, persuade or compel all classes to honor the Sunday. The lack of divine authority will be supplied by oppressive enactments. Political corruption is destroying the love of justice and regard for truth. And even in free America, rulers and legislators, in order to secure public favor, will yield to the popular demand for a law enforcing Sunday observance. So here we can see, what do the rulers do?
Also, hier können wir sehen, was tun die Herrscher?
Yield to popular demand.
Yes, they will yield to the popular demand, okay.
Also, sie werden der allgemein...
Ja, oder der, sozusagen, den öffentlichen Verlangen...
Sie werden der öffentlichen, dem öffentlichen Verlangen eben nachgeben.
Okay. And we can see the politicians continuously say, no, we don't make a vaccine mandate, it's not good, and blah, blah, blah. Yeah.
Wir können ja jetzt sehen, wie die Politiker immer wieder sagen, nein, wir machen keine Impfpflicht und so weiter.
Yeah, but you can see also, and then I will just show you some news headings, that now the people, and especially also, you know, people of influence, they now call for this vaccine mandate more and more rigorously.
Aber wir werden jetzt auch ein paar Zeitungsartikel lesen und dort werden wir sehen, dass eben die Leute und auch Leute, die eben einen Einfluss haben, sie rufen jetzt auf für diese Impfpflicht.
Okay. It says then here, next boldface, liberty of conscience, which has cost so great a sacrifice, will no longer be respected. Okay. So what your conscience says, they don't care about it anymore.
Also was dann dein Gewissen sagt, darüber sorgen sie sich nicht mehr.
In the soon coming conflict we shall see exemplified the prophet's words, the dragon was wroth with a woman and went to make war with the remnant of her seed, which keep the commandments of God and have the testimony of Jesus Christ. Okay, now let's go to this, here, this news article that I just copied here.
Gehen wir jetzt zu diesem Zeitungsartikel, den ich hier rein kopiert habe.
As you can see, it was from yesterday. Okay.
Und ihr könnt sehen, das ist von gestern.
And this is now here in German, but because it's taken here from Austria. Okay.
Und das ist jetzt also auf Deutsch, weil das eben aus Österreich entnommen wurde.
But it says here basically epidemiologist, or however you say it in English, Gardlehner brings in this general vaccine mandate into the play. Okay.
Also hier steht ja der Epidemiologe Gardlehner bringt allgemeine Impfpflicht ins Spiel.
Okay. And then he basically says you need vaccination rate of 85% to 90% to have control over the pandemic. Okay.
Also er sagt, du brauchst 85% bis 90% Impfrate, um die Pandemie zu beherrschen.
Okay, next news feed.
Nächster Neuigkeitsartikel.
It also says here Ärzte für weitreichende Impfpflicht, so doctors call for a vaccine mandate.
Also die Ärzte rufen für eine Impfpflicht auf.
Okay. So, and then also next news heading.
Und nächster Nachrichtenüberschrift.
It was just from today.
Und das ist von heute. Yeah.
Das heißt hier, Corona-Impfpflicht soll verfassungskonform sein, so they basically say, alright, we tested it and it's in agreement with the constitution, or it's legal according to the constitution in Austria to make a vaccine mandate.
Okay. Also sie haben hier gesagt, sie haben das überprüft und es ist eben verfassungskonform, also es stimmt mit der Verfassung hier in Österreich überein, diese Impfpflicht einzuführen.
Okay, but... what is also interesting, just when you go to the next page.
Aber was auch interessant ist, wenn man zum nächsten Bild geht.
You can see the infection rate of different countries here in the world.
Da kann man die Infektionsrate von den verschiedenen Ländern in der Welt sehen.
In the highest infection rate at the moment is in Gibraltar.
Und die höchste Infektionsrate im Moment ist in Gibraltar.
I don't know, in English, is it Gibraltar or how you say it?
Gibraltar.
Mark, do you know this?
The what, sorry?
Do you have the...
Gibraltar?
Gibraltar.
Is I've it? Heard it.
Okay. No, this is how...
We pronounce it.
Oh, Gibraltar, yes.
Okay, there you have the highest infection rate, okay?
Also dort ist eben die höchste Infektionsrate.
Okay, but when you go to the next image, right next to it...
Wenn man zum nächsten Bild geht, darunter...
In the right corner, down at the bottom...
Und dort in der rechten Ecke, ganz unten...
You can see that they have a vaccination rate among the populations of over 99%.
Okay. Und da kann man sehen, dass sie eine Impfrate der Bevölkerung von über 99% haben.
So basically, they are an example of what would happen if everybody would get vaccinated. Okay.
Also sie sind ein Beispiel für das, was geschehen würde, wenn jeder sich impfen lassen würde.
Okay, it doesn't work, right?
Also das funktioniert nicht.
Yeah, they're the country with the highest infection rate, but also with the highest vaccination rate.
Und okay. Sie sind das Land mit der höchsten Infektionsrate, aber auch mit der höchsten Impfrate.
Okay, so the Lord, he wants to rebuke them by showing these things. Okay.
Also der Herr will sie tadeln, indem er ihnen diese Dinge zeigt.
So, but nonetheless, the people, they don't know these things. Okay.
Aber nichtsdestotrotz, die Leute, die wissen diese Dinge nicht.
Yeah, because they get usually fed all these mainstream news articles where they continuously lie about the vaccination.
Okay. Weil sie eben beständig gefüttert werden von diesen falschen Nachrichtenartikeln, wo sie eben beständig angelogen werden.
So I just now copied some readers' comments on what I found now below some articles.
Und jetzt habe ich ein paar Leserkommentare hier eingefügt, die ich unter ein paar Artikeln gefunden habe.
And these are actually still more the harmless ones, okay? Because I couldn't find all these things that I read in the past days, which were even more aggressive, okay?
Und hier sind ein paar harmlosere, weil ich konnte die anderen, die ich schon vor ein paar Tagen gelesen habe, nicht mehr finden.
Okay, it says here, the first one says, I'm afraid we have to get used to the idea that about 10% of the population consists of asocial egoists who don't care about their fellow citizens or future generations. The whole argument, whether now in relation to climate change or corona, are actually only justifications why the own behavior would not be egoism, but somehow justifiable and rational behavior. Seen in this way, listening also makes little sense from my point of view. Isolating would be more appropriate to at least limit the spread of disinformation. Sad, but I fear this is the world we live in. So he basically states here that you should isolate all these non-vaccinated people.
Also hier sagt im Grunde, dass du all diese ungeimpften Leute isolieren solltest.
And what did we read about these national reformers? What did they say?
Und was haben die nationalen Reformer gesagt?
Send them to a desolate land, to the devil, and there they can build up their own country.
Okay. Sie sollten in ein verwüstetes Land zum Teufel geschickt werden und dort könnten sie ihre eigene Regierung aufbauen.
Okay, and we need to understand, the North and the South, they have the same mentality. Just one is with a religion, the other is without the religion. Okay.
Wir müssen verstehen, dass der Norden und der Süden, sie haben dieselbe Mentalität und nur der eine hat eben die Religion und die anderen sind nicht religiös.
You could see this with Hitler and Stalin. Okay.
Und das konnte man sehen mit Hitler und Stalin.
Hitler made all these concentration camps.
Und Hitler hat all diese Konzentrationslager aufgestellt.
And Stalin made all these concentration camps. Okay.
Stalin hat auch die Konzentrationslager gemacht.
And whoever was not in agreement with either of these leaders, they were put into these camps. Okay.
Wer auch immer nicht in Übereinstimmung mit diesen Führern war, der wurde dort in diese Konzentrationslager gesteckt.
And we can see also with these national reformers, they utter the same mindset.
Okay. Und das konnten wir auch sehen mit diesen nationalen Reformern, sie haben dieses selbe Gedankengut ausgesprochen.
And also here we can see already in the population, you have this dragon spirit already manifesting itself.
Und hier können wir das auch sehen mit der Bevölkerung, dass sie diesen Drachengeist schon manifestieren.
Okay, let's read the next reader's comment.
Lesen wir den nächsten Leserkommentar.
It says, if then probably more the tolerance of people who would purposefully divide society with false information and absolutely no sense of the common good can develop. I don't know if it very well translated, but it basically says, I have to tolerate them, but I don't accept them. Okay, so they basically say, yeah, all these anti-vaccination people, they divide the society with all their disinformation.
Also sie sagen, all die Ungeimpften, sie teilen die Gesellschaft mit all ihren falschen Ideen.
And he has to tolerate them, but he don't accept them.
Und er muss sie tolerieren, aber er akzeptiert sie nicht.
Next comment.
Nächster Kommentar.
Says here, wow, they still haven't understood the principle. When tolerance goes so far as to tolerate intolerance, tolerance dies. The intolerance is vaccination opponents working against democracy. So they basically now say that those that resist the vaccination, they also resist democracy and they basically try to undermine the government.
Okay. Also sagt diejenigen, die die Impfung verweigern, sie wirken gegen die Demokratie. Und was heißt?
And they try to undermine the government.
Sie versuchen die Regierung
zu untergraben.
Zu untergraben.
And what was Jesus accused of?
Und für was wurde Jesus angeklagt? Gegen was?
Yeah, sedition, right?
Aufruhr.
So basically, you don't submit to the government, you speak against it. You plan sedition. Okay.
Also wenn du dich nicht der Regierung unterwirfst, sondern gegen sie sprichst, dann begehst du Aufruhr.
Okay, next comment.
Nächster Kommentar.
Says the politicians are complicit because they do not enact mandatory vaccination by law. So this guy is already calling for this mandatory vaccination. Okay.
Also dieser Mann hier, der ruft jetzt schon zur Impfpflicht auf.
He says, legally, this would be possible and necessary for a long time. Fewer people would die, there would be fewer economic consequences and less division in society. The hesitation out of party political considerations is irresponsible. In the next comment, somebody who is already now triple vaccinated.
Und im nächsten Kommentar, das ist jetzt von jemandem, der schon dreimal geimpft wurde.
He comments on this thought that also now the vaccinated people should be, limited in their, in their daily activities.
Und der kommentiert jetzt über diesen Gedanken, dass auch die Geimpften in ihren täglichen Aktivitäten beschränkt werden sollen.
He says to this thought, such a nonsense. Why should I stay at home as a triple vaccinated person? People go and get vaccinated. And dear politicians, finally introduce a general vaccination mandate. Okay, so he also calls for this vaccination mandate and he says, I'm triple vaccinated, I'm perfectly safe. Okay.
Also er ruft auch zu dieser allgemeinen Impfpflicht auf und er sagt, ich bin dreimal geimpft, ich bin vollkommen sicher.
Okay. But we need to understand also a very important point. Okay.
Wir müssen auch einen sehr wichtigen Punkt verstehen.
Yeah. Why is it that the Lord allowed this virus to come?
Warum hat der Herr erlaubt, dass dieser Virus kommt?
Yeah, it's clearly a judgment, right?
Und ganz klar, es ist ein Gericht.
So whenever the Lord brings judgments, it's a rebuke. Okay.
Und wenn auch immer der Herr ein Gericht sendet, dann ist es ein Tadel.
So basically, what would be the right thing for the government to do to basically how should they educate the people now in order to better withstand this pandemic?
Also und was wäre jetzt das Richtige für die Regierung? Wie sollten sie die Leute aufklären, damit sie dieser Pandemie widerstehen können?
To turn to God and confess their sin.
Yes.
It's all disease is the result of sin. And when somebody wants to be healed, they have to know what first made them sick and confess it before the Lord will do a miracle to remove a pandemic or heal them or heal the land.
Yes. That's
also, true. Dass sie sich zu Gott wenden und ihre Sünden bekennen, weil man muss ja verstehen, was einen krank gemacht hat und das muss man dann bekennen, damit Gott dann man heilen kann und das Land auch heilen kann.
But I mean, this would not be so much the job of the government. This would more be the job of the church.
Right? Also das wäre ja nicht so sehr der Auftrag der Regierung, sondern mehr von der Kirche.
The government, although they are political, they should also be ruled by the same principles of God's law. So they should understand that.
Yes.
And there was a disease, I think it was in the United Kingdom. I'm not positive, but I think it was in the United Kingdom. And they were asking the government for help, but this politician understood the principle of hygiene and said and told them, go clean your streets, clean up all this, do that, and then the problem would be removed. So he pointed them to hygiene laws, which exactly. The Lord would then bless.
Mm-hmm. Also, obwohl eben die Regierung ja eigentlich politisch aktiv ist, sollte sie trotzdem auf Gottes Prinzipien hinweisen und ihnen folgen. Und es gab auch im Vereinigten Königreich irgendeine Krankheit, die ausgebrochen ist. Und dort hat dann, who was it, the president?
He was a politician, but also, I can't remember.
I have the quote here, I can post it.
Also das war eben ein Politiker und der hat gesagt, was sie alles tun sollten. Und wir werden das jetzt auch gleich lesen, damit diese Pandemie bekämpft werden kann.
Yes, it was cholera.
Also es war Cholera.
Cholera.
Mm-hmm. Die Krankheit.
Okay, so I posted it.
Also ich habe das in die Livestream Gruppe gepostet.
It says, when Lord Palmerston, Premier of England, was petitioned by the Scottish clergy to appoint a day of fasting and prayer to avert the cholera, he replied, cleanse and disinfect your streets and houses, promote cleanliness and health among the poor, and see that they are plentifully supplied with good food and raiment, and employ right sanitary measures generally, and you will have no occasion to fast and pray. Nor will the Lord hear your prayers while these, his preventatives, remain unheeded.
So he was rebuking the clergy, right? Exactly.
Okay. Yeah.
Er hat die Geistlichen damit eben getadelt.
So we can see, this is actually what the government should do. Okay.
Und das ist eigentlich, was die Regierung tun sollte.
Should tell the people, look, we have a pandemic, we need to get our lifestyle in order.
Also sie sollten sagen, schaut, wir haben jetzt hier eine Pandemie und wir sollten jetzt unseren Lebensstil in Ordnung bringen.
We need to make sure that we live now more healthy, we reject all these unhealthy habits and hobbies and all these things.
Okay. Und wir müssen jetzt sicherstellen, dass wir gesünder leben, dass wir all unsere ungesunden Gewohnheiten und Hobbys aufgeben.
And this would be the right thing for a government to do, no?
Okay. Das wäre das Richtige für die Regierung zu tun.
And then the church should have the role of educating the people, all right? You also need to confess your sins, you need to repent and turn to the Lord.
Und die Kirche hätte dann den Auftrag, dass sie den Leuten sagt, dass sie jetzt Buße tun sollen, ihre Sünden bekennen sollen und sich zum Herrn wenden sollen.
Okay. So, because when we now just read this next quote by Sister White.
Und wenn wir jetzt das nächste Zitat von Schwester White lesen.
Okay, let's just read this bold-faced here.
Lass uns das Fettgedruckte lesen.
It says, This is when Jesus asked Peter 3 times, "Do you love me?"
Da hat Jesus Petrus dreimal gefragt, ob er ihn liebt.
This heart-searching question was necessary in the case of Peter, and it is necessary in our case. The work of restoration can never be thorough unless the roots of evil are reached. Again and again, the shoots have been clipped, while the root of bitterness has been left to spring up and defile many. But the very depth of the hidden evil must be reached. The moral senses must be judged and judged again in the light of the divine presence. Okay, so the Lord always wants to reach what part?
Also der Herr will immer welchen Teil erreichen?
Yeah, he always wants to heal the root. Okay.
Er will immer die Wurzel heilen.
Yeah, but this worldly system, it only wants to heal the symptoms.
Right? Aber das weltliche System will immer nur die Symptome heilen.
So therefore, yeah, basically, when we consider the situation, the people, they are not called to change their lifestyle now, but they are just called to get a vaccination shot that they continue in their sinful ways of life.
Und wenn okay. wir jetzt einfach nur die Situation betrachten, dann wird den Leuten nicht gesagt, dass sie ihren Lebensstil ändern sollen, sondern einfach diese Impfung jetzt erhalten sollen und dann können sie fortfahren mit ihrem sündigen Leben.
Okay, and therefore yeah, the Lord can never bless them.
Und deswegen okay. kann der Herr sie niemals segnen.
Yeah, but God allows these things to make people realize, oh, I need to have a proper health, I need to be resistant against these viruses and germs and all these things.
Aber Gott erlaubt das eben, damit die Leute sehen, dass sie eben eine bessere Gesundheit brauchen und damit sie eben resistent sein können oder widerstandsfähig gegen diesen Virus und die
Krankheitskeime, genau.
Die Krankheitskeime.
Okay, so let's just read the next quote, and we're familiar with this. These quotes here.
Und lass uns jetzt das nächste Zitat lesen, damit sind wir auch schon vertraut.
It's from Ministry of Healing about prayer for the sick.
Das ist jetzt von Ministry der Heilung von über das Gebet für die Kranken.
It says God is just as willing to restore the sick to health now as when the Holy Spirit spoke these words through the psalmist. And Christ is the same compassionate physician now that he was during his earthly ministry. In him, there's healing balm for every disease, restoring power for every infirmity. His disciples in this time are to pray for the sick as verily as the disciples of old prayed. And recoveries will follow, for the prayer of faith shall save the sick. We have the Holy Spirit's power, the calm assurance of faith, that can claim God's promises. The Lord promised, they shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover, is just as trustworthy now as in the days of the apostles. It presents the privilege of God's children, and our faith should lay hold of all that it embraces. Christ's servants are the channel of his working, and through them he desires to exercise his healing power. It is our work to present the sick and suffering to God in the arms of our faith. We should teach them to believe in the great healer. I mean, this is perfectly fulfilled when we have really the Holy Spirit, but still we can look at these principles already.
Das ist natürlich vollkommen erfüllt, wenn wir den Heiligen Geist dann haben, aber wir können uns jetzt schon die Prinzipien anschauen.
Yeah, it says, the Savior would have us encourage the sick, the hopeless, the afflicted, to take hold upon his strength. Through faith and prayer, the sick room may be transformed into a Bethel. In word and deed, physicians and nurses may say so plainly that it cannot be misunderstood, God is in this place to save and not to destroy. Christ desires to manifest his presence in the sick room, filling the hearts of physicians and nurses with the sweetness of his love. If the life of the attendants upon the sick is such that Christ can go with them to the bedside of the patient, there will come to him the conviction that the compassionate Savior is present, and this conviction will itself do much for the healing of both soul and the body. And God hears prayers. Christ has said, if you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. Again he says, if any man serve me, him will my Father honor. If we live according to his word, every precious promise he has given will be fulfilled to us. We are undeserving of his mercy, but as we give ourselves to him, he receives us. he will work for and through those who follow him. But only as we live in obedience to his word can we claim the fulfillment of his promises. The psalmist says, if I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. If we render to him only a partial, half-hearted obedience, his promises will not be fulfilled to us. In the Word of God, we have instruction relative to special prayer for the recovery of the sick. But the offering of such prayer is a most solemn act and should not be entered upon without careful consideration. In many cases of prayer for the healing of the sick, that which is called faith is nothing less than presumption. Many persons bring disease upon themselves by their self-indulgence. They have not lived in accordance with natural law or the principles of strict purity. Others have disregarded the laws of health and the habits of eating and drinking, dressing or working. Often some form of vice is the cause of feebleness of mind or body. Should these persons gain the blessing of health, many of them would continue to pursue the same course of heedless transgression of God's natural and spiritual laws, reasoning that if God heals them in answer to prayer, they are at liberty to continue their unhealthful practices and to indulge perverted appetite without restraint. If God were to work a miracle in restoring these persons to health, he would be encouraging sin. It is labor lost to teach people to look to God as a healer of their infirmities unless they are taught also to lay aside unhealthful practices. In order to receive his blessing in answer to prayer, they must cease to do evil and learn to do well. Their surroundings must be sanitary, their habits of life correct. They must live in harmony with the law of God, both natural and spiritual. To those who desire prayer for the restoration of to health, it should be made plain that the violation of God's law, either natural or spiritual, is sin, and that in order for them to receive his blessing, sin must be confessed and forsaken. So here we can clearly see the Lord has a completely different approach how he wants to end this pandemic than the world does.
Und hier haben wir können wir ganz klar sehen, dass der Herr eine andere Angehensweise hat, wie er diese Pandemie beenden möchte, als die Welt hat.
He wants to tackle the root problem and he wants to change people's lifestyles.
Er will das Wurzelproblem erreichen und er will den Lebensstil der Leute eben ändern.
Yeah. Which is the cause for all these diseases, you know, that come upon people.
Okay. Und das ist der die Ursache von all diesen Krankheiten, die auf die Leute kommen.
And and therefore this is something that also the governments need to understand. Okay.
Und das ist auch etwas, was die Regierung verstehen muss.
Instead of oppressing people and forcing these poisonous drugs upon people.
Und anstatt, dass sie die Leute zwingen und ihnen eben diese
giftigen,
giftigen Medikamente ihnen aufzwingen.
Yeah. They need to understand that the Lord has a plan and his plan is much better than what they try to do.
Und dann müssen sie eben verstehen, dass der Herr einen Plan hat und sein Plan ist viel besser als das, was sie tun.
And this is, will be also, I believe, part of this testimony that we need to give them.
Okay. Und ich glaube, das ist eben auch ein Teil des Zeugnisses, das wir dann ihnen geben müssen.
That they can see that God has a much wiser plan to to heal this pandemic than what they do.
Dass sie dann sehen können, dass Gott einen viel weiseren Plan hat, um diese Pandemie zu heilen, als das, was sie tun.
Okay, so therefore to summarize, we can see basically this same oppressive spirit that the North or the South has, we can see it already manifested here in this situation at the moment.
Und um zusammenzufassen, wir können jetzt eben schon denselben unterdrückerischen Geist sehen, der sowohl den Norden als auch der Süden hat in dieser Situation im Moment.
And as they will demand, as the people will demand for a Sunday law, so the people are more and more demanding now for a vaccine mandate.
Und so wie sie das Volk das Sonntagsgesetz fordern wird, so fordern sie jetzt auch immer mehr und mehr die Impfpflicht.
So therefore it's just a matter of time. Okay.
Und deswegen ist es nur eine Frage der Zeit.
And if it doesn't come this winter, it's only by God's grace that he extends our probation a little bit longer.
Okay. Und wenn es nicht diesen Winter kommt, dann ist es nur Gottes Gnade, die unsere Gnadenzeit ein wenig verlängert.
But at the moment you can see already this dynamic that it can go pretty quick. Okay.
Aber im Moment können wir schon diese Dynamik sehen, dass es sehr schnell gehen kann.
And people are less and less afraid to manifest what they really think and believe. Okay.
Und die Leute haben immer weniger Angst davor, das zu zeigen, was sie wirklich glauben.
And therefore, we need to make sure that we guard and basically equip ourselves.
Und deswegen müssen wir sicherstellen, dass wir uns hüten und dass wir uns ausrüsten.
And that we can really show them a better way.
Dass wir ihnen wirklich einen besseren Weg zeigen können.
And that they can realize that their ways are false and that God's ways are right.
Und dass sie dann realisieren können, dass ihre Wege falsch sind und Gottes Wege richtig.
And therefore, may the Lord help us to know, really compile all these arguments and that we can then have a clear understanding for ourselves, that we can then have answers for our faith.
Und deswegen möge der Herr uns helfen, dass wir all diese Argumente dann zusammenbringen, damit wir eine klare Antwort dann für unseren Glauben haben können.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay. Then I would say we can close for this evening.
Also dann würde ich sagen, wir können für heute Abend abschließen.
And let's have our prayer round.
Und lass uns unsere Gebetsrunde machen.